Hey everybody, how's it going? It is me, the Cosmic Turtle. Thank you for joining me on part 2 of Darksiders playthrough on Apocalypse difficulty. So let's get started then. We left off last time just after freeing Samael, so I suppose now is the time that we get one of those hearts for him. Saying if that cancelled out my flight, I'd be a bit annoyed. If you're gonna be killed now. Ah, sweet, sweet. Didn't I? I don't think I remember too much of my first playthrough of this game, which will make it entertaining. That I'll be able to re-experience some things at least. I believe I already finished Darksiders 2 on Apocalypse, so when I finish this, I think I might give that that more difficulty a turn. The one death one, which, well, I'm expecting it to be ridiculously hard, but like a really good challenge. Because on my first two playthroughs of Darksiders 2, the game kind of ripped me off. Because I got to level 30, but I never got the achievement for actually hitting level 30. Oh shit. So, if anything, this second playthrough will be a good opportunity for me to get that achievement, which I was never given. I can imagine how horrible it would be to actually finish it on the difficulty the first time, then having to start it a second time to hit level 30 and then dying on the second playthrough. Oh, I'd be ridiculously upsetting. Okay. There's an achievement for doing this if you jump across a certain number of them. Obviously, as you can see, it's more than two. I've got two of these now for Volgrim. Ah, zombies. What is a game without zombies? Ah, least these ones are more skeletal warriors than actual zombies, but then these ones are basically zombies. Technically, I suppose they're like the husks of Mass Effect, but they have such like a strong zombie feel to them.
Journey, you may come into possession of certain items that are of particular interest to me.
Yeah.
Artifacts of the Fallen Legion. If you discover any Legion artifacts, bring them to me. I will make it worth your while.
You say that, but... Thousands doesn't feel worth my while. Now give me that something, Bolgrim. Hey everyone. How much does it cost?
Samael has returned you in one piece.
Cool, yeah, it's automatically equipped. Annoying how late into the game they make you wait to get your horse. It'd be so useful at this part of the game. Just in terms of speed, that's what I'm doing.
Destroyer. My brother spoke of your coming. But a powerful curse holds me now. I cannot help you.
Any curse can be broken.
Yes, perhaps. These servants of the Destroyer walk unseen within the realm of shadow. By their blood we are bound. By their blood shall we be free.
I can no longer move within the shadow realm. Much of my power has left me.
Shadow Realm, it's like Yu-Gi-Oh.
You need not enter it.
We need Marek or Yugi.
I will grant
Yugi.
You the power to see into the accursed realm for a time. But to what end? What hope have we now against the Destroyer's foul sorcery?
Hope will not bring you freedom.
You got it, Joker. I wonder, I take this car with me. No. A lot of dead people. I hope they're not gonna raise up and try to kill me. are far too many people. Okay.
Surely this is no challenge for a master to you.
I think it's a bit quicker. Yeah, much quicker. Skulls. So what are you doing changing targets for, your penis? That second one really isn't necessary. First one cuts their legs off. Most of those really gonna be a threat anymore. We have your fault. Call it eyeball.
Excellent.
Okay. I really love how like reminiscent of The Legend of Zelda this game is. Like, overall. Because it has the whole dungeon thing, killing the bosses, increasing your health bar. Each dungeon requires a new item you find only in that dungeon. I'm not sure if they could have ever made a game as good as The Legend of Zelda, but I would have liked for them to have more than two attempts. You know, the second one was a vast improvement on this, introducing the whole loot system and everything. Would have been nice to have seen what direction they were going in. I still think a four-player game where you, like, cooperatively play as all four of the horsemen would have been amazing. I suppose it'd have to be a bit like Diablo. Kill 50 enemies before war. Oh, okay, so. Kill them while I'm dying. Does my Abyssal armor still work? This one will give me health. The Abyssal armor makes this so easy. Drain in health? What? Thank you. enemies. Oh, there was a lovely chunk of my health. It's a good way to end the challenge. May as well take all the boxes, you know. No one else is going to need them. It's not like death or pestilence is going to be coming through here after me and getting killed because they had no health chests. Right then. On to the next swine who needs to be killed. And of course, by swine, I mean eyeball. Aerial brawls. Okay. Oh, I remember this last time I accidentally skipped it and I didn't realize what I had to do. Ah, okay, hit him. Once too early and I didn't mean to hit him then. Yeah. That count. Hey, victory was mine. A lot quicker than I thought it would be as well. Victory, thy name is Turtle. I really need to make myself like a logo. I think I'm gonna just like draw a picture. It'll probably be. I don't know if I should do like a turtle, like a ninja turtle. Like, so he's standing up on two legs. Or if I should just do like a normal-ish kind of turtle, just like on all fours. But I definitely want to put him in space, in like a space suit. and maybe a bit of a Silver Surfer vibe on like a surfboard if I decide to make him a Ninja Turtle style turtle. So I could even like, if I made him like the other kind, I could just make him like look like he's flying in space on two legs, you know, give him a humanoid kind of form. And give him like Doctor Strange, how he has like his hands glow like with cosmic-y powers. Give him that kind of feel. Come to me! Ah. Stupid bats. Being so open to dying. It's annoying, it's such a fun game to play. To be fair, that's probably budgeting problems more than anything. I just didn't have the money to actually be able to put the time in to make more animations. Ending on that big guy. Why aren't I grabbing it? There we go. Fairly certain if I kill him, it summons him number one. I can't really be asked to fight two of them. It sounds like there already is two of them. Yep, now there's two of them. Ah, okay. Shit. Oh, there's a nice, easy one. Alright, last one. Do you want to log on to the big one? And there we go. So many other people got knocked about from that animation. Block counter, okay. Was reflex never walking along. Okay, so just press RB right before you get hit. Again as well, I like how I like how they implement health and stuff in this game, making it more of like a reward to get your health back, rather than like a privilege, like on number 2 when you can find health potions and just use them as you need them. I'm not sure which one I prefer. Oh, and I'm fairly certain, I'm not going to do it now because I don't want to waste everyone's time, but I'm fairly certain there's also a secret chest here for breaking certain tombstones. I think it's the big cross ones. Just to be safe, just break them all. I think it is break them all. Ravager. Increases war's damage. Ah, okay, yeah. It's a weapon enhancement. Alright, let's chuck it on then. Chuck it on the safe, because it always feels like the safe doesn't do much damage, so. This playthrough, I'm also going to be going for the, I can't remember what the achievement's called, and I'll stop attacking cars while I'm talking about it. You know the achievement for upgrading all weapons and gaining all combat abilities? I'm going to be going for that one, so just before I get given the new sword, I may have to like hang around for a bit killing things to make sure my Chaos Eater goes up to level 4. That's the problem I had in my first playthrough. I got it like 3 4/5, like proper close. And then I got given that bloody new sword. It could be me being stupid, it might have still counted. But I just assumed that that's like the trick to the achievement. If you don't do it before that point, you can't get it on your playthrough. So when it comes to that achievement, I probably won't record the entire process of leveling each weapon to level 4, because probably going to take a long time, and I doubt you want to like sit through like say 6 hours of me attacking with the scythe. You know, I'll make a video maybe as each weapon, what's that, is about to hit their max level, or I might just do it as I'm about to get the achievement. About the possibility of a Dark Soul, a Darksiders 3. Do you think it's going to happen? And if so, do you reckon they're going to use a new rider, or they're going to be a bit lazy and somehow implement the same tool they used, but into a like slightly modified story. I'm not sure how they could do that, and personally I hope they don't. I don't know which one I want, because one of them has it like, one of them would feels like it'd kind of be a Gears of War style game. Sylph, I believe they called him in this one, is the one with the two guns. So couldn't really make his an action like hack and slasher like this one. They'd definitely have to give him some close range weapons or something, because it wouldn't feel like Darksiders if he spent the entire game shooting things behind cover. But they'd probably just have to focus a lot more on the shooting aspect of the game. Which I'm okay with, I think it could work. What's the other one have? The other one has like a whip or something, doesn't she? Like the fourth rider. I don't really know what they would do with the fourth one. Or they could implement that one as the third one, who knows? Like, it seems like a tricky one, because whip combat, as far as I'm aware, it's not really the biggest form of fighting. But again, in these games, you don't have one weapon. You always have multiple. It's just they are, like, the primary weapon of choice. So you'd probably get something else, because, you know, in number two, Death could use a hammer and a giant axe. So he was never forced to use your dual scythes. Or one giant scythe. Just like on this one, War uses a sword, but he got a scythe. I think if they can manage to find a way to make the story good, I think the ideal number of Darksiders games is no less than 5. Because they'd have to do one game for each rider, and then one final game with all the riders together. Which they could either implement it as a, like, each rider has their own level, you can play it co-op and bring in the other riders to fight with you. Or as I mentioned earlier, like a Diablo style game where you go through basically the same story with each one, but you get to control each one and play the game completely different depending on who you pick. To be fair, I just hope it happens. I'm a huge fan of this franchise. I have been since I first played it, when I played number one. Sadly though, I am not a day one player. I didn't know about this game on day one. I did get number 2 on day 1 though.
Come on.
I see a weird black thingy, which means there is a increase chest. I think that's green. Oh, one more. I get myself a nice health upgrade. Well, that's one card didn't want to fall off the edge. Maybe that's better. So is there any games that any of you are like really looking forward to in the next year or so? Or any games that you hope gets made that haven't currently been announced? Comment, let me know your thoughts. Oh. I haven't fought one of these yet, have I? Scared him with my war cry. We need in those. Oh yeah, I have done this trick. I remember the Shoryuken. Or maybe I've done a Shoryuken to someone else. Who knows? I do love the fact that he does a Shoryuken though. Nice little collection of souls coming along now. I never noticed that anvil up there. Like, I noticed it when I had to do it for story purposes, but I didn't realise it actually had them there for the entirety of the game. Silly, because it's kind of a tease making you think it's better than it really is. Okay, I didn't. I don't know if anyone else has noticed that like weird pink sound in the background every now and again. It really reminds me of someone shooting a torque bow on Gears of War and like hitting a wall. If I hear it again, I'll draw attention to it. Angels are back.
This way.
It's nothing. Some demon trick.
I know what I saw.
What did you saw?
He's right. It's there, beneath the stench of this place. You can sense it, Angel. From neither the White City nor the Black Depths, something lost between.
Come on, boy, you got this. Fucking out me way. Interception. You can try, but you will not succeed. Yeah, I remember this part of the game. I felt like it dragged on way too long. Oh yeah, I forgot to control the I don't know, what are you? You're like a griffin. Of all the things this game did right, this section and this crosshair is not one of them. Moves way too freely and like fast. There's an achievement that can be gained by here, I believe it is, for getting a certain amount of kills. Anyway, I guess rid of him. Ah, yep. The fuck should it? Twice. Throws a car and a flying griffin thing. Come on, just die, please. Oh, I really, really don't like this part of the game. Oh, I can't, I'm only four. This is blocking it. I assume, geez, that's a lot of how many kills do you just get? The new part I like about this game is that it's like a nice little preview of things to come. You get to see the hell, the characters, some of them, the environments. still don't forgive it for being ridiculously long though, because there's no need for it being as long as it is. Or at least make this bloody thing faster. Hurry up and die, you stupid dragon demon thing. Looks a bit like Final Fantasy's Bahamut. When I think about it. Is this the end? Is this freedom? Is it finally over? No, apparently not. Oh, someone attacked me. Great Bahamut is back. Oh, it's you, the Bat Queen, King, person. Can't remember what gender you are. I'm finally off that bloody thing. Oh, feels good to be on solid ground again. Feels fantastic, actually.
Tiamat, I assume? Guess she wasn't up for having visitors today.
I'll get you, just let me go. That's a bit of an unexpected song, just out of nowhere. Nothing, Bobo. Nothing at all. Okay, there's crystals there, so... yeah, that's nothing else. And let's get, I suppose this is technically the first dungeon. Fine, I will kill you. Let's get dungeon number one out of the way then.
Over here.
Let's hope I can remember the puzzles enough to not have you waiting around for me while I try to remember them. Come on, Griffin, you got this. It's only like twice your size. you for making this convenient bridge for me. Okay. So, this is the dungeon, I believe, where I get my gun. Or I get something at least that attacks range. Right, yeah, okay, I've got to push the statue and break the floor. Just have to remember how to get up there to push the statue. Covered with red, which means he'll open when I kill these. I gotta go through here, find myself a key to go through there. Or maybe I gotta go through here to drop the statue, then find the key. I do like these elements of the game, like, I don't know how you'd call them, per se. Platformer elements, maybe? No, however you'd say them. I do like their inclusion into the game. It feels like it helps give it a more unique touch, because most games have like the hack and slash kind. I know like quite a few do have it in there, but look at the map. Right then, is one of those bombs up here so I can blow up that? Or have I got to do that from somewhere else? Optional treasure chest, by the looks of it. Right, then let's go down that hole. I always wondered where it disappeared to. Because, you know, this wooden floor looks quite easy to break, especially since it's just smashed through like concrete. Like, there's not even like a wing or something, it's just vanished. never understood how it just disappears, but there. Welcome to my video. And it's all random and weird. Maybe a little creepy as well. Sure, make me run back. These guys don't waste any time coming back to life. Is the one or is it the two? Oh, okay, these two are back. Okay, so we got the key. So now we can go back to the area with the fountain and go through the door. Right, here we go. Let's see where this takes us to. Looks safe here, apart from the lava, of course. For the most part, it looks quite safe. This looks like a mini boss of sorts. Of sorts. It's not going to be just you though, is it? Reminds me of that, if you ever played The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, reminds me of that fight with the Black Knight. Except, of course, in Zelda you don't cut off his arm, then cut him in half. I can't really remember much of that fight, I just remember that he reminds me of it. Done. That's one section of the dungeon complete for now. Let's go across and open the other side.
Over here.
Yeah, I know. Well, tell me over there as well. Abyssal armor. I think I preferred the color of this original suit just because I prefer red. Come on, Griffin Man. You got this. Hold your own. Go for the throat. Okay. Sword here. Okay, there you go, I got it. Just rid of that. Gosh. Did not see that. Let's get rid of that as well. Get your swine. Huh. Okay, I can do this. Oh, yeah. What? That'd have been so funny if it grabbed the enemy. Take this guy out. I got this sword and I've blown up this, so I suppose. Oh, okay, that was just an optional thing. Oh, my health bar increases now at least. Okay, so we chuck this sword here. See what the next room has in store for us. So far this has been quite like a straightforward dungeon. There hasn't been any anything too tricky. But okay, can I drop down? Let's try and grab that collectible. We make it? Yeah, we made it. This is our first champion artifact. So, I suppose this will help us get to the other half of that room, which was blocked off by a giant pit of lava. Well, I could be wrong. Climb up. I'm not falling for that again. Well, I suppose the outcome was I was wrong. That's not what that that was for. I wonder, is that statue going to disappear? Or are you going to... Yes, where did they go? There's not even a, like, not even a single sign of this statue. No rubble, nothing. I don't get it. Oh no, an enemy ran down here. Oh, he thinks he ambushed me. Last man gets to face my sight. Okay, okay. What up here? Ah, okay. New item. Do I have to kill something before getting my item or after it? Ah, the shuriken thing. I can't remember what his real name is, but... I assume you're going to tell me what his real name is now. Or are you just going to call it shuriken? Ah, oh, crossblade. Okay. Okay, don't wanna let me... Oh, you swine. Oh, great. Just what I needed. Smelly man. Like a doom kill that is, just pull his head off. With the spine, okay. No, that's more of a predator kill. Do 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 do. Thank you. There's one of you. So should be able to see the other one from right here. Okay, cool. a noise. All right, the door. Yes, that makes sense. The door is making weird noises at me. Do I have a key? No, okay. I've already done one. Where the piece of wood came from? Ah, yes. I remember this room. I didn't like it. Or maybe it was one of the rooms coming off this room, but either way, didn't like it. Right. Okay. Must stop the lava flow so I can get the sword. First off, what do you do? Okay, you try to turn it right, okay. No, down please. You're an idiot. Didn't you grab on the thing under it? Okay, screw it, let's just do it this way. But these ones only set off if I hit them with fire. So let's chuck you over there. This took me a very long time to remember how to do the first time. Right then, that's the first part of this bit then. There we go. So stay in the middle. I want to be on this side. Chuck you about by there. You can go up by there. You go up by there. And just to be safe, we'll chuck you there. Please be close enough to each other. Good man. So, I believe that gets rid of half of the lava flow. What are you doing on the floor? Thank you. return it, please. Let's grab this collectible down here. If I just jump in the lava, should take me back up to the top. Hopefully it doesn't put me back where I just jumped off. It's just mocking me now, isn't it? Oh. It is mock. No, I'm mocking me. Okay. Quickly. You're an idiot. Okay. Done. And when I get over there now, that will be the end of this area. Sword. One down, two to go. I don't know why that keeps doing that, if you've noticed from time to time. If I go past, like, constant animations, I suppose. Sometimes they follow me. Like every now and again, the glow off that orb will stay on my screen. Similar to like the lava just did. Yeah, what's happened then? Okay, room number two. What have I got to do here? Looks like I've got to start off by doing this. Room number two. Oh yes, yes, I remember this room. The music's a little bit late. Ah, your penis. Not sure who's the penis, me or him. New group of enemies. Thankfully they're not very strong. And there is, whereby is the explosive? So now if you want to, oh there it is. If you want to break everything and get all the collectibles, I'm sure you have to like repeat yourself a little bit. Could be wrong, and maybe I just done it weirdly the first time. Sure, this one's the optional one and not actually the correct way, or I could be wrong. That looks like the correct way to me. So that's the way you want to go, story-wise. But We want to get up there and get that item. Let's have a check. Try hitting this one. There we go. So you have to hit the second one you come to. You also come to this hidden one. Yeah, that raises all of them, so now you haven't got to worry about any nonsense. That's how you get back out of this place. After you have claimed this new shiny sword. Wow, that was ridiculously lucky. I'm fairly certain he was supposed to just, like, jump for the rope. Interesting. Oh, okay, I'm an idiot. See, look at how much more useful that is. Now we have to go back to here to re-hit this one. It's followed swiftly by a trip back to this one. Right, now we can get out. This takes us to the third and final sword. Crow's gonna fall or something, isn't it? I knew it wouldn't be that easy. Those three, and I send in the big guys. Really? Interesting. Oh, I see, I see. Not the third and final key. Sword. Oh, look, a nice bit of lava. Wait a minute. Let's do the quicker way. It would be funny if you fell back up. that? No, that's not all of them. Yeah, I think that's all of them. Okay, so we have a lever over here. We have a door. Let's see what you do first. The lack of doing. Ah, yeah, okay, I remember. Slowly make a bridge. Wait a minute, am I supposed to like... I remember now. Kill him like the trolls in Fable 2, but not quite as easy as the trolls in Fable 2. Conveniently a little door. Well, resuscitate. Right, I'm gonna have to end this here for now, and I will finish this dungeon later on today. So I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please subscribe, like, and I hope this was useful.